Whenever you are getting an idea or whenever someone is sharing an idea, all your blood cells, there are about 120 trillion blood cells in your body, all those things get pumped up. Today onwards, I am going to do this, yesterday onwards. Once you go out of that classroom today, over, sleep, that's all, tomorrow onwards, what happens? Then routine work is done, everything is gone, away. So planning, I plan to do this one, I plan to do that one, all those things, planning. We are human beings who plan very well, very good planners. Right? So thinking to do something and doing what we actually think. I repeat, thinking to do something and doing what we think has only one difference. That difference is called laziness. And it is also contributed by one important factor. This factor called as wow factor. So what is this called? Wow factor. W-O-W. Wow factor. Wow. What's called wow? Whenever we are going to start something new, when you are going to plan something new, this factor comes in. What others will dash. Fill it. What others will think, what others will comment, what others will say, what others will do, all those things will come into your mind whenever you start. Right from today morning, since we choose our dress, to choosing our own career, we think of what others will say, what others will speak, all those things. We plan very well, excellently, fabulous planning. Study hall days, day one, these many lessons, day two, these many lessons. We plan very well, excellent planning. And we end up doing nothing, zero. We eventually think of others only. We depend on others, what others will speak, wow factor. So my dear brothers and sisters, keep this in mind. WOW, what others will think, should not even hit your mind. Psychologically speaking, your subconscious mind knows very well what is good, what is bad for you. It knows very well. But this lateral mind, outer mind, surface mind, what it thinks is, it depends for others. Yes or no? Obviously yes. Definitely. Since most of the group here belong to the college groups, I could say one simple example. Like many people, see, if for example, some four or five boys are there, okay? Four or five boys are there. Suddenly a girl passes by. So what one guy does is, he shouts, "Hey, she's going. What this guy says, "Hey, shut up, don't do this one. But what instead he feels, yes, say me more, all those things. Yes or no? This is what is it is, wow factor. For the surface mind, we know very well that it is, yes, this is not needed. But subconsciously, we think we want all those things. So we live in this concept of called wow factor. What others will think. Try to eliminate this out of your mind today onwards. Don't just plan anything. If you want to start your work, the first step is to begin. That's what my idea is all about. To begin, the first step is going to be begin. Start begin. Eventually, everything will come and fall into place. That's very important. Am I clear? And when I ask to many people, how do you define passion is? What do you call passion? This is my passion, this is my interest, all those things. How do you define passion? When I was working in the IT industry, I decided to resign my job on December 30th of 2014. I just went to the manager. My manager, "Sir, I want to quit my job all of a sudden. I cannot give you a notice period, just I want to leave the company." Because my passion was into training, teaching, writing, etc. So he was asking me, "What are you going to do without any goal or plan or something? How are you going to start your own company?" But I was not bothering about anything. I just want to do something. Many people sitting here are doing something which is not actually interested for you. Your job, your education, whatever work you do, most probably we are doing something which you actually don't like. So what actually makes you happy and which actually makes you happy? I'll tell you one thing, my dear brothers and sisters, one simple thing. Whenever Monday mornings and Friday evenings, do not change your mood, you are in the right job. Yes or no? Whenever Monday mornings and Friday evenings, do not change your mood. How do you feel every Monday morning? Sunday night itself, ayyo, tomorrow college, tomorrow office, all those things will happen. But Friday evening, or probably Saturday evening, what comes to your mind eventually? One type of enjoyment, fun comes to your mind. Why? That we don't know. But anyway, fun, so Friday evenings are meant for fun. So when Monday mornings and Friday evenings, do not change your mood. You are in the same, I mean, same wavelength means the job which you are going to do, which you are actually doing is liked by you, loved by you. That's very important. You are doing it for yourself and not for others. That's the point here. I want to go to college or I have to go to college. What's the difference here? How many of you coming here, I want to go to college? No, I have to go to college, that's it, simple. These two have a huge difference, right? So when I resigned my job in the company by December 30th, I gave the notice, I mean resignation letter to the manager. And it took 2 days to come to my hometown, packing all those things, 2 days. December 31, January 1, done, gone. January 2, I started my own company, that's it. My friends were asking me, what's the plan you're going to do? No, there's nothing to plan, no plan. We got a first client, I just started working towards my goal. January 2 was the birth of my first company by 2015. That's the case. I got my client, first client, and then just going on. So my thought was that, if you plan something, eventually you will fail. If you want to start something, start. Start doing. In the process, definitely you will be getting lot of obstacles, challenges, all those things. Face it. You will get solutions to face also, definitely. Still, I remember the day when I was going to meet my first client in my two-wheeler, I was going there, okay? When I was going to the particular place, it struck my mind that without an ID card, they won't allow you inside, in that particular client place. And by the time, I was not even having a business card or an ID card by the time. I was just riding. Then when this condition struck my mind, I just stopped my bike and I went to a stationery shop nearby. I took a cardboard, chartboard, all those things, and I sketched myself, trainer. And I took a 5 rupee lamination sheet and just pinned in my shirt and went inside. That's all, first ID card, gone. Now, last week when I was cleaning my cabin, my room in my office, that particular 5 rupee ID card comes to my mind now, in this hand. In this moment, when I see this ID card, what feel will I be getting? No words to explain that feel, yes or no? It's like just, I at this point of time, I was looking back at my life. When I started at 2015, 3 years of journey, I started with this 5 rupee ID card. Now we have gone to a lot of sophisticated ID cards with us. So all it was like a single point of time, a simple get to start beginning without any serious plan. That's very important. All right. So next thing is this one. I'm not sure how many of you are very aware of this fact called the placebo effect. We say it as, scientifically they say it as placebo effect. I'm not here to explain what this placebo effect. I'll tell you a simple story. Tell me if you can understand this one, all right? There is a military camp, okay? There is a military camp. Two soldiers are heavily injured. They are like, doctors are rushing here and there to treat many soldiers. So in one particular camp, there are two soldiers who are severely hurt. Doctor comes in fast. The two people are like so much of in pain, they are like crying, so please make it fast. Doctor came fast and he took the bullets out and for one soldier, he injected, okay, morphine. You know what is morphine? Painkiller. He gave morphine. And you know what, within 10 minutes what happened? The pain subsided and he fell to sleep, subsided, okay, gone. The other soldier was watching this continuously, whatever is given. Doctor says, for you also, I'm going to give morphine, and he went inside the room. Unfortunately, there was no morphine, it was over. There was only distilled water, sterile water was there. You know what he did? He just took the distilled water, came back to him. Please adjust, I'm also going to treat you with morphine, just show me your hand. He is treating with the distilled water alone. You know what happened? After 10 minutes, the other soldier also slept. Pain was relieved. So what made the other soldier also relieved from pain? Which one made? His own belief, extreme belief of something, extreme belief. That extreme belief is proved as the placebo effect. And they tested the blood samples of these two soldiers also. The same chemical reaction, whatever happened to the soldier who was treated with morphine, same thing happened to this person also, same. There was no change. So extreme belief of something, he witnessed the other soldier who was actually treated. So that is the extreme belief you need. If you want to follow your goal or plan or something, never make any plan or of something, nothing. If you want to start, start, that's it, start. And have that extreme belief that it will happen for sure. It will happen for sure. Extreme belief. And I am a person who strongly believes in the concept of this, positive thoughts, positive vibrations. Many people used to say is, think positive, stay positive, all those things. Listen to my words. If I say, don't think of chicken 65. What comes to your mind now? But what did I say you? Don't think of chicken. So whatever I'm saying, don't think of something, you will think of that only. If I say, don't worry. No problem, yeah, problem. So whatever you are thinking as negative, it will happen for sure. The mind, the same mind will be reflected as the stuff of the universe also. Universe reflects whatever we think, positivity. Am I clear? So people used to ask me, okay, I'm going to think very positive from now onwards, very positive. Once I enter this hall, I will start planning towards my home, positive. So now tell me, for one day, how many hours I have to put my efforts? Should I work for 10 hours? Should I work for 20 hours? All those things. Imagine, my dear brothers and sisters, I'll tell you only one thing, simple. Every single day you are going to put one unit of work. Every single day you are going to put one unit of work for 365 days. 1 power 365 is equal to 1. So every single day if you invest one unit of work for 365 days, what happens? Your result is 1 mark for you, normal life, goal achieved. What I suggest for you is, the idea which I am going to share to you now is, add 1% extra to it, just 1% extra. Instead of putting 1 unit of work every day, add 1% extra, it becomes 1.01. You know what the result is? Look at the result. 1.01 per 365 gives you 37.78 is the answer. So what's the increase here? 37 times increase, which is nothing but 3600% increase in your result, output. So all you have to do is just make one simple step, 1% efforts, extra efforts every single day, you will get this 3600% higher. Alright, next, most important thing. Many people have got lot of confusions in their mind, lot of confusions, this, that, all those things, confused mind. When I was learning this part of the psychology, my psychiatrist asked me, the same thing I'm going to tell you also. How many of you sitting in this hall, how many of the audience? Every single night, whenever you go to bed, okay, whatever thoughts you get, or whatever you text, or whatever you see, whatever you listen, whatever thoughts, when you wake up in the next day morning, same thoughts continue. How many of you in that house here? If you get so, the entire night your brain has not slept at all. Your brain has not slept at all. Psychological concept. Serious concept. Have you ever experienced this on a Sunday, on a weekend? After a very heavy meal, we used to sleep for 3 or 4 hours. Have you experienced this one? We used to sleep for till 6 or 7 o'clock we sleep. And once you wake up, we'll get a heart attack. Ayyo, what happened? Which day it is? Monday or Tuesday or whatever, I have to go to college, all those things. Have you ever experienced this? If you have experienced this one, that is the best sleep you have got. You might not have got dreams in those sleep. That is actually called this alpha state of the brain. Alpha state of the brain. So, 5 minutes before you go to bed, and 5 minutes immediately you wake up from bed. Whatever is happening, that is called alpha state. Brain has got different states of sleep, 4 states of sleep. The first state is called alpha state. And in this alpha state, if you think any goal or wish, 200% it will happen for sure. Happen for sure. Have you experienced this also? Whenever you want to buy a mobile or a car or a home, whatever it is, you plan to buy something, deep desire is there, you want to buy something. Have you experienced this? Whenever you plan to buy, after that you will see that object everywhere. Newspaper, someone is using there, all those things you will see. Till then you might not notice that. Only after you desire, you will be noticing those things. Universe will give you all possible solutions. So this is what I say it is, alpha state. And people used to say, don't postpone things, do it, don't tell I'm going to do it from tomorrow, do it today onwards. My style is, don't say I'll do it today onwards, I'll do it from this moment onwards. Now onwards, I'm going to do this one. No plan, nothing. Just start doing this moment onwards. And it's time for me to end now and for you to begin now. Keep one thought to begin. Thanks a lot.